So welcome dear students and the viewers. This is 12th lecture on Python programming, and in this class I am going to discuss about passing the quiz on passing mutable and immutable objects to Python functions. So on the screen you can see the quiz that I have given to you, and there were 10 questions each carrying 1 marks. So it was a total of 10 marks, and we will discuss all the questions today in this class. In the previous class I had told you about passing mutable and immutable objects to Python functions, how you pass, how the values get changed, etc. All those things we had seen. So let's discuss the first question first. The first question is about passing integers. Okay, so in this case we are passing, there is a variable a. So let me show this program here. This is the same program that I had given to you, and here the execution of the program will be like this. First this will get executed, a is getting value equal to 20, and then we are printing the id of a. Okay, and then we are calling this function fun1. So as soon as you call this function, you know that this a out here and this b out here, they will be initially pointing to the same variable. Okay, I am not drawing the diagram because I had explained it in the last class very elaborately. So I am not going to draw the diagram. As I tell you, you just imagine how the diagram would be, and I hope you will be able to do it. Okay, so first this a out here and this b out here, okay, they both will be pointing to the same variable, okay, same object holding value equal to 20. Okay, but now as soon as you are writing b equal to 20, okay, so still a and b will be pointing to the same object, because a is having the value 20, b is also holding the value 20. Okay, and you know that integers support object reusability, so both will be pointing to the same object, and hence if you print the id of b here, then you will get the same address as a. So nothing is getting changed. If you print id here, if you print id inside the function, or if you print outside after calling the function, they both will have the same value. And you well know that why it is so. You can draw the environment also for the local and global environment, and then also you can see that all these three addresses will be same. So let me run this and show it to you, that you can see that all these three are same. So the answer of the first one will be 101 101 101. ID addresses may be anything, it doesn't matter what values you are taking. I have just, for simplicity, I have taken them as 101 101, but in general it will be a big address, something like this, okay, as you can see on your screen. Okay, but for simplicity reason I have taken a smaller address, 101 101 101. Okay, so let's see the second question. And now what will happen is, so this is the program, and here you can see that first a is equal to 20, you are printing its address, and then you are calling this function fun1. So initially this a and this b will be pointing to the same object. Okay, and you know very well that this will happen in case of any type of object, whether it is mutable, whether it is immutable. Initially this b, this local b and this global a, they will be pointing to the same object. Okay, so now you are, but after this you are assigning value b equal to 30. So as soon as you do this, you see that the values are getting modified. Okay, so initially a is pointing to some different object, and now you are assigning b equal to 30. Okay, so it will now start pointing to some different object. Had it been 20, it would be pointing to the same object, but now you have changed the value, so this b will be pointing to the different object. Okay, and if you print the address, it will be different from a. So the address, this address of a and this address of b will be different. But as you come out of this function, as after this function call, if you print the address, then the address of a is not getting changed. Nothing is happening to the address of a. As soon as you come out of this function fun1b, then the environment of fun1 will get destroyed and b will no more exist. The global variable a will exist, and it will still be pointing to the same object holding value equal to 20. So that is how its execution will take place. So this address, this IDE A before the function call and this IDA after the function call, they will be same, but this IDB out here, it will be different. Okay, so let me run this and show it to you. So as I told you that the initial A address and the address of A are same, but the address of B is different. Why? Because you had assigned a different value to B. Okay, so the output of this will be 101, 102 and 101. So initial two values will be same, but the middle one will be different. Okay, let me come to this and show me the program first. So this is the program, and as I had told you in the last class also, that here you, when you are calling fun1a, this a and this b, they will be pointing to the same object, okay, irrespective of which object you are talking about. As soon as you write like this, this essentially means that local a, okay, equal to global a, okay. So you are not changing anything. Initially it will be pointing to the same object, okay. Initially they both will be pointing to the same object, okay. Now you are printing the ID of b, so you know that since they are pointing to the same object, the address of a out here that you are printing, and this address and the address after the function call, all these three will be same, okay. You are not changing anything. Although it is a tuple, do not get confused, although it is a tuple, this relationship will still hold, because you are passing this a here and this b is here. So this a and this b, this argument and this parameter, they both will be, this parameter a and this argument b, they both will be pointing to the same object, okay. So if you print the address will be same, okay. So let me run this and show it to you, and you can see that all these three addresses are same, okay. So let me take the output, and the output will be 101, 101 and 101. So the last option is correct, okay. So now let's come to this, and here you are writing DEF11B, and then what you are doing is, so let me first open this program, and then we will see what is the output, okay. So this is the program, and here you can see that initially this a out here and this b out here will be pointing to the same object, but what you are doing is that now you are doing an assignment operation, and even though you are using the same value, okay, a different object will be created, because tuples do not support object reusability, okay. So this a out here and this b out here, they will be different objects, okay, they will be pointing to different objects. The reference variables a and b will be pointing to different objects even though they are holding same value, okay. So if you print the address, it will be different from a, but when you come out of the function, then the address of a will be same as the previous one. The address of a is not getting changed. So if you print the address before function call and after function call, they will be same, but this address out here will be different, and you know why. Okay, so let me run this and show it to you. You can see that the initial two addresses are same, but the middle one is different, because tuples do not support object reusability. You are doing an assignment operation, and you are assigning, although you are assigning same value, a different object will be created, and hence its address will be different, okay. So the output of this should be 101, 102 and 101, okay. So let's come to the next question, and this is okay, so let me first open it. Okay, so now again, you are for the same reason here, a is there. Initially this a, this b will be pointing to the same object, but now you are assigning a different value, so definitely it will be pointing to a same different object, okay. Initially it was 1790, but now you are making it equal to 1890. That is, you are assigning a different value. Even though it was same value, it would be pointing to different object, okay, because tuples do not support object reusability. So this b must be pointing to a different object, and this address of a will not get changed even if you print it before function call, after function call, they both will be same, but this address out here will be different. The address of b inside the function will be different, because it is holding a different value, it is pointing to a different object. So let's run this and show it to you that the initial two addresses are same, but the middle one is different. So the correct options would be 101, 102 and 101. Okay, so let's come to the next one, and again a list, mutable type of object, and this is your program number 6. So let's first open it. Okay, so this is the program, and I told you that this a here, this b here will be pointing to the same object. So nothing is getting changed, a and b are pointing to the same object. So if you print their addresses, they will be pointing to same object. You are not making any assignment operation inside the function. So this a and this b, they will be pointing to the same object, okay. So if you print their values, then they will be same, their addresses will be same. So all these three addresses will be same. You are not making any modification, okay. You are not doing any assignment operation, okay. So nothing is nothing will be changed. Okay, so you can see that these three addresses are same. Okay, so the correct option will be 101, 101 and 101. Now let's come to the next question, and this one says, this is the same question. This is different. Okay, now you are doing what you are doing is that you are doing an assignment operation. Okay, so let me open this PRG7, and you can see here that now you are doing an assignment operation. So as soon as you do assignment, you know that list does not support object reusability. This B will now start pointing to a different object. So this A out here, okay, so this address and this address will be same, but this will be different even though it is holding the same value, because lists do not support object reusability. Okay, so initially this A and this B will be pointing to the same object, but as soon as you do this assignment, this B will now start pointing to a different object, and hence it will be different. So the address should be 101, 102 and 101. Okay, that is, the first two addresses will be same, but the middle one will be different as expected. Okay, so this is 101, 102 and 101. Although I am running the program and then ticking the correct output, but you are not supposed to do like this. You do not run the program, you just do the logic and then tick the correct option. Okay, otherwise there is no meaning of it if you simply run it and write the output. Just for demonstration, I am demonstrating all these things. Okay, so you first reach the conclusion, then if you want, once you submit the quiz, then you can run the programs and then you can see what are the outputs. Okay. So, okay, so let's move to the second, this question. This is program number 8, I guess. And this is PRG8. Okay, so a very good question. And you see, here you are printing values, not the addresses. Okay, so if you print the first, it will print the value of A, that is the output will be 7090. Okay, 7090. Now, when you are calling this function, this A out here and this B out here, they will be initially pointing to the same object. Okay, but now what you are doing is that you are doing an assignment operation, so it will now start pointing to the different object. Okay, and besides that, when you perform an append operation, it will happen in the different object that was created due to B. Okay, so when you did B equal to 1790, a different object was created, and the append operation will be performed in that new object, not in the previous object. Okay, I hope you understand what I am trying to say. Okay, you can draw the environments yourself and you can see what is happening actually. Okay, so when you are performing append operation and when you are printing B, then the output will be 7090 and 100. So let me write this here, 7090 and 100. Now you come out of the function, but you see that A has not got changed. Okay, there is no change in initially A was here, A was pointing to an object holding value 7090, but and initially B was also pointing to the same object, but you did B equal to 7090, so B started pointing to a different object. Okay, and it is not pointing to the same object as A. Okay, so whatever modification you did, whatever append operation you performed, that happened in B but not in A, that will not be reflected in A. So if you print the value of A outside the function, okay, after the function call, it will still remain the same, which is equal to 70 and 90. Okay, so if you run this, you can see that 7090, 7090, 100 and then 7090. As expected, you can see whatever output I have written here, the same output you are getting when you are running this program. Okay, so this will be the correct output. Okay, now let's come to this question number 9, the second last question. And so let me open this first. Okay, so now what you are doing is that here A and B will be pointing to the same object, and if you perform an append operation, you know that append is not going to change the object. Okay, I had told you in the last class also that only assignment operation will change the object. If you perform append operation, since list is a mutable type of object, you can perform modification in the existing object, and this is actually happening in the same object as A, because here you see, here A is pointing to B or B is pointing to A. They are pointing to the same object holding value equal to 7090. And when you are performing append operation, okay, the append is happening in the same object as A. okay, because you have not performed any assignment operation before this, okay, you have not performed any assignment operation here, okay. That means this A and this B, they both will be pointing to the same object. So now what will happen is that this A will get modified, okay. So what will be the output? You are first printing A here, output of this print statement will be 7090. Okay, now you are calling this function, and when you are calling this function, the control will go here. A and B will be pointing to the same object, and if you perform the append operation, this will give you the output 70, 90 and 100. When you are doing this print operation, okay, so the output will be 70, 90, 100. Now you are coming out of this function, and you can see that this actual A has been modified, okay, because both A and B were pointing to the same object, okay. So this A has been modified, and if you print the value here, then it will give you the modified value and not the original value. So the output will be, the output will be 7090, okay. The output of this program will be 7090, then it will print 7090, 100, and when you come out of the function call and print the value of A, it will still give you 7090, 100, okay. So let me run this and show it to you, and you can see that you are getting the same value as expected, okay. So now this is your second last question, and the output will be 7090 100 and 7090 100, okay. Okay, so next question, again you are performing an append operation. So this is very important and a different question, okay. So let me show it to you what is happening actually here. Okay, so this was the question, and you can see that when we are performing this append, initially this A and this B will be pointing to the same object, and when you are doing this append operation, this is happening actually in A. Okay, you are not doing any kind of assignment before this append operation. That means this A and this B, they will be pointing to the same object, and when you are performing an append operation, this will happen in the original object, the global A. Okay, so the global A will now get modified, and this will now become equal to 7090 100. The global A will become 7090 100, because A and B, they are pointing to the same object. But now see, what you are doing is that you are assigning a different value to B now, okay, and as soon as you do this, the B will now start pointing to a different object, okay. B will start now pointing to a different object, okay, not the same object as the global A, okay. The B will now start pointing to different object, because you have performed an assignment operation, okay. And if you print the value of B, you will get 4, 5, 6, okay. But you see, the original, the global A has not been affected, okay. B has now started getting pointed to a different object equal to 4, 5, 6, but the actual A, the global A, has not been modified, okay. So if you print the value of A outside the function call, it will still give you 70 and 90, okay. So what will be the output of I hope you got this program. This was bit different from what you have seen till now, okay. Nothing to worry, when you are performing append operation, this B is still pointing to the global A, okay. So if whatever append operation you are doing, you are actually doing in this global A, okay, and it will become 70 90 100, okay. And when you are doing B equal to 4 5 6, B will start pointing to a different object, and hence it will get a different value, but the value of A will not get modified. Sorry, when you print it after the function call, it will become 70 90 100, because it has been modified by this particular statement, okay. So what will be the output? The output will be, first it will give you 70 90, because you are printing here, so it will give you 70 90, and then you are calling this function. As soon as you call this function, okay, the control will go here, and you are printing the value of B, so the output will be 4 5 6, and then after the function call, the value of A has been actually modified, okay, because here A and B, they were pointing to the same object, okay. So if you print outside the function call, or in the main after the function call, then it will be the modified value and not the original value. So this should be the output, 70 90 4 5 6 and 70 90 100, okay. So let me save this and run it, and you can see that whatever I have written here, 70 90 4 5 6 and 70 90 100. So this is your expected output, and so this should be the correct output, the third one, okay. So let me submit this and check my score. Okay, sorry, I made a mistake. Okay, so anyway, let me do this again. This will be kind of revision for you also. So you are doing this here, b equal to 20. So this will be 101 101 101. Addresses will be same. Then you are writing here id of b. So this will be a different address, 101 102 and 101. And then you are writing here id of b. So this will be the same address, 101 101 and 101. And then when you are coming here, the output should be 101, and it will be a different address now. So 101 102 and 101, this should be the output. Okay, now when you are doing here again, 101 102 101, and here it will be the same address, all of them will get same address. Here it will be different address, 101 102 and 101. Here it will be, you are performing a assignment operation before append, so it will be done in actually a different object. So 7090 7090 100 and 7090, and here you are performing append operation in the same object, so it will be 7090 7090 100 and 7090 100. Here you are performing an append operation first, and then you are assigning a different value to b, so it will be 7090 then 456, and then it will be 7090. Okay, sorry, 7090 100. So 7090 456 and 7090 100, that is your expected output. So now let me see the score, view score, and you can see that I have got 10 out of 10, that is every response is correct. Okay, so that's it for today, and I hope you got the concept. I hope this concept of passing mutable and immutable objects to Python function is clear to you. In the next class, I will teach you about recursive function, or maybe we will solve some more questions from the pre-board question papers of different regions based on passing mutable and immutable objects. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay indoors.